Hey, hello guys, welcome to WikiWorks channel where the search for the truth begins. So this is DARPA part 3. This is not a conspiracy theory. What are we going to discuss in DARPA part 3? Why was DARPA started? When did they start DARPA? We said in the previous video that the internet was developed by DARPA. But the information in our books mentions that ARPANET developed the internet. How is it possible that DARPA developed the internet? Is DARPA developing technology against Russia? We have discussed RoboHuman and Facebook, but the content seems to be from a sci-fi movie. Will this happen or not? How to believe in this theory? Before 1992, the internet was considered to be a sci-fi movie. But now, in 2020, it is known that we can speak through the internet to anywhere in the world. But if we say this in 1992, people will call us fools. So every technology developed is done this way. On 4th October 1957, USSR launched a satellite called Sputnik to space. America was surprised after hearing this news. Americans were developing luxury technology like TV and so on. The Cold War was happening at this time, but in the USSR, they concentrated in science, technology, and space. America thought that USSR would defeat it if it continued in the path. What was the reason behind America's fear? There was no internet in those times. There was only telephone communications. So if an enemy bombs a territory, that must be communicated via a telephone. These were all wired telephones. America feared that the USSR would disconnect the communications. They also feared that the USSR would dominate the space. After 1958, American educational syllabus changed. Physics, chemistry, and biology became important subjects. So Americans wanted to advance in technology. America decides to form two organizations. The two organizations come under Title V, which says that Federal Acquisition Streamlining Act of 1994 law is not recognized. There is a category called red tape. These two organizations will not come under the red tape category. The documents will be tied by a red tape. These are important files, so the records of these two organizations don't need published documents for the public. ARPA after years changed to DARPA. ARPANET was changed to the internet. ARPA conducts research. They send out requests to many scientists and companies. The question is whether the USSR's Sputnik satellite has been launched. What is America's reply? If communications are disconnected, what can the American government do? Universities like MIT began to show their research. In 1962, DARPA announced that JCR Licklider had developed the Galactic Network. The theory of two computers communicating with each other was proved. So in 1962, JCR was hired by DARPA. In 1965, they developed packet switching. They discovered that a message can be sent as small packets through a network. They discovered that computers in different locations can send messages as packets with each other. This is when they introduced ARPANET. This was the birth of ARPANET. Using ARPANET, they connect two computers. They send a message called login from one computer to another. Unfortunately, the other computer did not receive the full message, but it received LO. The remaining letters disappeared. DARPA again started their research. After many tries, the same message was delivered to the other computer. So, in 1970, only four computers were connected through ARPANET. A university in Hawaii developed another network called AlohaNet. So DARPA wanted to connect both the networks. DARPA develops Transmission Control Protocol. Thus, ARPANET became the internet. So through Transmission Control Protocol, which was developed in the 1970s, which is called internet, was made public in 1992. So they allowed the public and companies to use the internet after 20 years of development. For 20 years, they were into research, infrastructure, and the profits they can earn all were calculated. DARPA was involved in various research in these hidden 20 years. DARPA didn't do one or two projects. Their laboratory means university labs. The maximum workforce of DARPA is 120 to 300 employees. What is DARPA's role in research? If there is a brilliant professor in a university, they give him a project. If there is a scientist working in a lab, they give him a project. So giving projects to many people and taking the output from them is the work of DARPA. There are so many projects which have been completed by DARPA. Are there possibilities that DARPA is trying projects which come in the sci-fi movies? There is a huge possibility. Synthetic blood is DARPA's main project. This project was started in 2008 and it's still running for 12 years. DARPA announced that synthetic blood will be available to the public in 2017. What is this synthetic blood? America is at war at all times. DARPA was given a project for developing synthetic or artificial blood. America's soldiers are stationed in Afghanistan, Iraq. Soldiers get hurt and the supply of blood has been delayed. Due to this, many soldiers have lost their lives. This was the reason behind developing synthetic blood. We will discuss in detail about synthetic blood in the next part. Next comes mind control arm. Soldiers who have lost their legs and hands are huge in numbers in America. A project which allows the soldier's mind to control an artificial hand or leg. DARPA wanted to create insect machines. They also have a project to travel from one star to another. There are many projects which are considered high-level projects. We are going to identify each and every project of DARPA. The success rate of those projects, DARPA's secret projects. Why are the details about these secret projects haven't made public? Let's discuss this in the next part. Comments about this video are most welcome. Please do subscribe and share for more content to WikiWorks, the voice of Tamil Pokisham. Please give a like to this video and please hit on the notification icon. Nandri, Vanakkam.